This is a update I'm doing on the lower receiver I'm building from scrap parts. It's almost completed. All I need to do now is to drill and tap the buffer tube. But everything else is finished on it, and as you watched videos I did before, I was having problems with the magazine release button. This is a standard button here, and what I did was I made one out of aluminum, and I'll show you what the difference here is on this one. Is because I attached these panels I built to the side, it wasn't long enough, so I made one out of aluminum, and you can see the difference here in the size of them, but this clears the thickness difference in the plate that was added on here, so that takes care of that issue. The other issue I had was the safety. Because these plates were added to the side, the safety wasn't long enough, and I didn't want to have to cut down in here or recess this at all. So what I did was I took a piece of 3/8 round stock steel and I made a new safety selector switch. Ground it down, put the two detents in there, and then what I did was I cut apart an existing safety, and you can't really see it, I don't know if you can or not, but I cut a groove in there and then slotted it and threaded it on there. So that took care of that part of it. And as you can see, it's fully functional. The other part was the rear takedown pin and how I was going to address that. And what I ended up doing on that was I basically took a bolt, I think it was 5/16 bolt, and I ground the threads off it, cut it, and I used the shank part of it, rounded it off, milled the slot in there with the two detents, and now you can see that when that is pressed in, it comes all the way through. So this is just a quick update on what I have done with it so far. The front takedown, I don't really have a problem. I don't know if you can see that, but it does almost come all the way through. And I did drill the detent hole down through here. So now the front takedown is operational. That works like it should be working. Like I said, the only other two things I have to drill the hole for the bolt catch, and then I have to drill the hole for the buffer tube. One other thing I did, you'll notice not a butt plate on here, and this stays in place, is I threaded this with a 440 hex head nut there, and you can see it locks it in place now. So now I don't need to worry about that falling out of there, and it doesn't need the plate on there to keep that in place. So it's just got a small 440 set screw in there, and that works really well for what I'm trying to do with it. So this is just, like I said, it's a quick update on where I am on this and how far it's come along so far. Just a couple more things, and then I'm going to throw an upper on it, and I'll take it out and try it out. I've been trying to round off some of the sharp corners that were on here and get it all smoothed out. And the other thing I did was I put stainless steel screws in here. Now when I do complete this and get it all set to go, I'm going to put Loctite on all these screws so I don't have to worry about it coming apart. But other than that, everything on it is just about done. Well, and the other thing I had to do was, for some reason, maybe it's because it was thicker, I don't know, but when this would come through, it would bind right here, the magazine release. So I just took a round file and I just put a bevel in there, and now that took care of that issue. It doesn't catch anymore like it was, but it's coming along. It's just something I'm playing around with right now. I just wanted to see if I could do it or not, and so far it's turning out fairly well. I don't have any issues with it so far. It looks like everything on it's going to operate and function as it should. And like I said, this video is just to show you what you could do if you ever do scrap one. You see, the magazine operates as it should. The other thing I talked about before was making some longer hammer and trigger pins, but after I look at it and see how everything functions, I think I'm going to just leave that alone. I'm happy with it. But everything functions like it should so far. So the other thing I'm going to do, but I'm going to do this, the very last thing I'm going to do after everything's put together and everything's operating and I know everything works right, is I'm going to put some roll pins through here to lock this tower in place better, because right now it's just got this screw in the back. I mean, it locks it in place good, but I'd rather be safe than sorry, so I'm going to put some roll pins back there just to make sure that that doesn't go anywhere. But it's just a quick update, show you where I'm at on it. It's, like I said, it's almost complete. Not much more to do on it, and it'll be finished. You can see the, I like that better actually. The magazine button sticks out quite a bit further. It's easier to access it. So, you know, just something I built just to have something different that would be more functional for me on this particular lower. So anyone out there that's watching this video and you want to get some ideas on what you can do if you ever do scrap a lower receiver when you're machining it out, this might give you some ideas. I mean, yeah, it's taking a little bit of work to do it, but it's just something I've been playing around with over the last week or so, just to see if I could do it. And so far, everything looks like it's going to turn out good. So, hope you enjoyed the video.